Hey, and welcome back to Chuck's Tuesday Tips, Why Measure and How to Make a Manikin Part 2. Okay, last time I left off, we were skinning the pig, and I had started the head measurements, and then I had told you that the correct way to measure the carcass is with the skin off it. So here's our completed specimen skin. I went ahead and did all these different measurements. You can email me and I can send you a chart if you want. I sent them out to some people before. And it's just basically every single measurement that of the anatomy of the specimen, like the shoulder height, for example, the heel to the elbow or wrist to elbow, again, heel to knee, etc. So anyway, now that we've done that, the next step is to start stripping our carcass. The first step is you have to cut the head off, because the head we boil out so that we can attach it later, and it needs to be a little bit cleaner than the rest. So I'm going to set that aside real quick. One thing I do to all my specimens is I make a quick Bondo mold. Like for example on this fox here, for reference later on. So I'm going to start that. This is some mold relief. And because it doesn't have to be a fancy dancy silicone mold. Just for reference for later on when we go to sculpt our specimen in. And I make it just a two-piece mold. On some of your bigger animals, like a deer, you have to make a three-piece mold to get the head out. So I'm just going to pour a little of this over half of the head right now. And then when it kicks, I'll pull it off and make the bottom half. So you can do that and start that while you're doing something else. And I kind of let it drip over the sides for the top half, because you don't want to make a natural lock, like for example when I made how to make a possum head, and then it turned out to be how to make a possum head that you can't get out of the mold video. So there we go with that. I'm going to just let that go. Now, we start disarticulating our specimen. And then we just start, it's a real simple process. You just want to strip the meat off the bones. And the only real trick to it, I'm sorry I'm not looking at the camera at you because I got to look what I'm doing, is you want to keep what we call the landmarks. Like for example, here's the elbow. That's a landmark, that cartilage. So we don't want to cut that part off. But we want to just get all the meat stripped off, leaving our landmarks. And you got to do it to the whole skeleton. Now, again, this is not like beetle cleaning or disarticulation or whatever you call it for museum quality skeleton, because this is all going to get covered with clay, foam, etc. And we're gonna make a mold off it. And then once we're done, the sad part is you end up throwing away your whole sculpture. So I'm cleaning this as an example. And you don't want to, like, see how this is gonna start. You got to be careful. You want to try to keep it all together at the joints. And sometimes it's real easy to get carried away and cut stuff off you don't want cut off, and then you got to put it all back together. And when you're at your mentor's shop, You get hit in the head with a 2x4 and stuff like that. What I have here is some salt. When you get down to the bone closer here, you can take salt, rub it on, and it helps to peel away all the meat. And again, it doesn't have to be 100%. Like I said, it's not for like for museum. You can see here now I'm down to the scapula. I've got that almost. And the scaps are kind of easy to cut because they're not as solid on something this small as it looks. So it's easy to cut off. When you see on a mannequin, you see that crease in the shoulder, that nice crease line? That's this bone right here where the, what do you call these two muscles now? I can't even think. Bicep and tricep connect. So, anyhow. So here we have this almost done. Again, you can rub salt. Or another thing you can do is when you get it close, you can, you know, leave it tack up like I like to do when I'm fleshing hides, and come back and it peels off. As long as you get it, you know, fairly quickly. And so you just repeat that process through the whole animal. Now the ribs are a little bit different. The ribs, you want to try not to disconnect the ribs. The problem I have right now is, normally I would gut this thing right now, but YouTube will, hell, it might even block this, you know. So I just wanted to show, you know, stripping the thing as best we can without taking the guts out so it doesn't get banned. And once you get used to it, you can see it's already starting to, you know, come down. Once you get do this a little bit, it won't take you long to strip one out at all. And see that again, we just repeat. Now the back has a joint, unlike the on a game animal, the front shoulder doesn't have a joint. It has this scap, it just comes right off. There's no socket here. Anyhow, I think you get the idea. And you just do this to the whole skeleton. Rub it down real good with salt. Then the next step will be to come in and reassemble the skeleton. And that's what we call setting up the armature. And so a lot of times when you hear me talk about something sculpted, it's not sculpted off a skeleton. The real way to make a mannequin, the correct way, is to use a skeleton and the skull. A lot of guys do a lot of other methods. They'll just carve something out of foam. They'll take measurements and this and that. But nothing beats having the skeleton, because you know it's right. And nothing beats taking measurements on your mounts, because the tape measure doesn't lie. The hunters, I won't say they lie, I'll say they exaggerate. For example, every pig ever shot is 300 pounds. Every bear ever killed is 10 feet tall and 1,000 pounds. You know, so hunters like big, but if you measure, you can at least give them back what they really got. So you can see just how this is working out. Here's your, this bone here, femur or whatever the hell it is. All the bones are all called the same things as on a human. So anyway, I'm going to continue on with this, and this will be the second in the series. next time we tune in, we'll have this thing cleaned and we'll try to assemble it. Again, the head part is boiled out, but not boiled and cleaned like for a European mount. It's just cooked so the meat's off it. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time on Chuck's Tuesday Tips.